This video is part of my Udemy courses. See the description for more info. Hi there, in this lecture we're gonna download GameMaker and make ourselves familiar with its interface. Let's quickly go through how we can get GameMaker. You can buy it either from Steam or from the YoYo Games website. If you got it from Steam, it's gonna handle downloading and installing it. And if you got it from the YoYo Games website, then you need to log in on the website, go into your account dashboard, where you can simply click on Downloads and get the GameMaker setup. Installing GameMaker through that setup is easy enough, and after it is done installing, it's gonna take some time to start up because it's installing the runtime and a few other things. So after that is done, you will see the GameMaker welcome screen. So let's go through this interface and the basics of creating and managing a GameMaker project. With this button, you can make a new project. With this one, you can open a project. But most of the time, you'll just be opening your projects from this recent projects menu. And then we have import, and this is used for importing projects that you or someone else exported for sharing. Let's click on new, and now we are asked whether we wanna use drag and drop or GameMaker language. Now this course is about GameMaker language and coding, so we're gonna go with that. And here we simply have to name our project and its folder, so I'll just enter GameMaker introduction. Our project is now created, and we are inside the main GameMaker interface. This is where you'll be working for most of your project, so let's see what we have here. GameMaker projects are built around using assets to build your game. So on the right, we have the asset browser, and on the left, we have the workspace. The basic workflow of using GameMaker is that you create and manage all of your assets in this asset browser, and you work on them in this workspace. So let's first take a look at the asset browser. Here we have folders for all the different asset types in GameMaker. And to create an asset, you can go into this menu. Now as you can see, there are a lot of asset types, so we're gonna boil it down to the three most important ones, which are sprites, objects, and rooms. To keep it simple, I'm gonna delete the folders for the other asset types, and we're gonna focus on these three. First, let's go under rooms, and you can see we already have a room here, so let's open it, and this opens up the room editor. This is where you create the levels or the world of your game, and you do that by placing objects. So we're gonna create an object now. I'll select the objects folder since I wanna create an asset here. Then I'll go into this menu and double click on objects. We now have a new object asset here, and we can name it whatever we want. Usually in GameMaker, you start your asset names with a prefix, and the prefix that I like to use for objects is O, so I'll name this O my object. Now the properties for this object are gonna open up here in the workspace. This is where you program an object and its behavior. Now let's go into our room editor and place our object here. You can drag it from the asset browser and drop it anywhere in the room. Now here you see a circle with a question mark because the object doesn't have an image assigned to it, and we are gonna work on that in a minute. Now you can place the same object in the room as many times as you want to build your level, and these are called instances. As you can see, there's only one object here, and from it we have created three instances in our room. So for example, this object could be an enemy, and you could place that enemy in the level in multiple places. Now we're gonna give this object an image, which is called a sprite. I'll click on the sprites folder, then go here and create a new sprite. This will create a new sprite asset, and I start my sprite names with an S, so I'll name this as my sprite. Now the properties of the sprite are gonna open up here in the workspace. And for the sprite, you can either draw an image in GameMaker or import an external image file. To draw your own, you can click on Edit Image, which will open up the image editor. Now by default, this image will be 64 by 64. So if you wanna change that, you can click here and enter the new width and height here. I'm gonna be importing an image file, so I'll click on Import and select this file. That image is now imported in our project as a sprite. Let's apply it to our object. I'll open all my object. Go into the properties and click here to set a sprite. In this menu, we need to select a sprite, so I'll select as my sprite. and the object now has that sprite assigned to it. Now if you go in the room, you're gonna see that image on the instances that we have here, and this is how you set what an object looks like. Now you can run the game by clicking on this button or by pressing F5. The compilation process will then start, and then the window will open up. This is the most basic workflow of creating a project in GameMaker. You add a sprite, then you assign it to an object, and you place that object in a room as an instance, and the room represents your level or the world of your game. So you can see that the room editor is an important part of GameMaker because this is where your game comes alive. We are going to play around with the room editor and see how it works in the next lecture. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can watch more tutorials from here and make sure to subscribe for more GameMaker content. I'll see you in the next video.